particularly good show against Jody Ballard. Now there's Lyle back with the right and the right again. But now the right is half point. The snap is gone. Look at them. Falling over each other. Dead tired. 25 seconds left. Ledoux with a right. Coming to the end of the fight. There will be no knockout. Winding down. The end of the fight is here. So there it is, and Lyle pats Ledoux on the head. Ledoux lifts his arms as if he feels the victory is his with those late round rallies. We'll see what happens. We'll be back in a minute with the decision.
Judge Harold Buck scores 45-44. Ron Lyle.
Very close there.
Judge,
I gave Lyle six rounds to four.
Scores 45-44. Scott Ledoux.
So, at the very least, a split decision. Interesting,
Judge,
eh?
Scores 46-45 for the winner, Ron Lyle.
Ron Lyle gets a split decision. I'm interested in the scorecard of the man who voted in favor of Scott Ledoux. I really am, because Lyle dominated from the fourth round through the eighth. Well, it was a Pier 6 brawl, not very pretty, but there it was. And Ron Lyle will go on fight.
And spiritual, a champion, and that's what I intend to do, man. I'm blowing out of there.
Ron, just before the fight, Jerry Cooney refused interviews with us. Does this say to you anything about his mental state?
I can deal with that. I can deal with that. I'm in the me. You know, I'm in the me.
Thank you very much, Ron Lyle. And now back to ringside with Marv Albert.
All right, Larry, and here is Ron Lyle entering the ring. He is not the favorite of the two here at the Nassau Coliseum.
Well, he's not very often been the hometown boy.
And you hear the cheers in the background. Now that means that Jerry Cooney, who is the hometown boy from nearby Hutchinson, Long Island, is making his way toward the ring. Here comes Cooney. Receiving the recognition, a good showing against Lyle tonight would be another step in that direction. Aside from his last three bouts, the only so-called name that he's fought and beaten, Eddie Animo Lopez, back in January of 1979, a decision in an eight-round bout. So this, a very significant fight here this evening.
You know, you wonder at this point, Marv, what's going through a veteran like Ron Lyle's mind. He's been in with Muhammad Ali. He's been in with Ernie Shavers. He's been in with George Foreman. What does Jerry Cooney mean to him?
It's obvious what Jerry Cooney means to this crowd. It is a standing ovation. Go to the public address announcer, Jimmy Leonard.
Here we go, Tiffany Promotions, Incorporated of New York. Sam Glass, President, and Muhammad Ali, Professional Sports of Santa Monica, California. Sam Marshall, President, and Lauren Cassina, Cooperating Promoter. The featured event this evening, 10 rounds of boxing and featuring two top world-rated heavyweight contenders. Ladies and gentlemen, the winner, in all probability, will have a title shot at the winner of the Gary Crooksey-Mike Weaver bout. Commentating at ringside, Marv Albert with the great Sugar Ray Leonard. officials appointed by the New York State Athletic Commission. And by the way, it's the chairman, Jack Prendeville, and appointed judging at ringside, Carol Castellano. At ringside, judging in front of me will be Harold Leatherman. Timekeeper at the bell, Freddie Offatello. Keeping count of the knockdowns at the bell is Johnny Lobianco. Ringside physician, Dr. Frank Guarino, assisted by Jose Paterno. Everybody must sit down. We cannot have a bout till everybody is seated. Ladies and gentlemen, presenting the contestants in this great 10-round heavyweight bout. Introducing on my right, out of the blue corner, wearing red trunks and a blue stripe, a very game veteran ring man, having had 47 as a pro, winning 27 of these by knockout, hailing from Denver, Colorado, and weighing in tonight, a trim, rough, and ready 211 pounds. He's fought them all, Ron Lyles. Now, ladies and gentlemen, as his opponent, really needing no introduction the world over, a local boy from Huntington, Long Island, weighing in at his favorite weight, 225 pounds, white trunks and a green stripe. He got everything asked of him in the boxing game, the title hopeful, the undefeated Jerry Cooney. The man in charge in the ring, the referee, Arthur Mercante.
Coming off the victory over Jimmy Young, Ron Lyle with battles against Young, but several years ago, so really you can't get any feel out of that trip.
Well, Cooney looks very motivated, the crowd, the intensity, you can really feel it.
Ron Lyle looking a little hefty in the midsection. What do you make of that?
He looks trim. Ron Lyle looks really trim. I think he's going to go right at Cooney and try to stop him in the earlier rounds.
One underway. Jerry Cooney in the white with the green stripe. Ron Lyle in the red trunks. Scoring is round by round. Winner of each round receives 1 to 4 points. The loser is 0. Referee and two judges score the fight. The bell will not save the fighter except for the final round. Three knockdowns in any single round would end the fight. Mandatory 8 count. And the chant of Cooney from this crowd of about 10,000 here at the Nassau Coliseum. There's the left hook of Jerry Cooney.
I think Lyle's going to be surprised with the power of Cooney. He knows the way Cooney goes to the body. He throws the left jab and then digs that left hook to the body, to the midsection.
Ron Lyle can punch, but does not have fast hands or fast feet, and has a bad habit of dropping the left hand after he jabs. Can be hit with the right every time he drops that left. That's been his major problem. Combination. When Muhammad Ali beat Ron Lyle back in 1975, he took advantage of that weakness by Lyle. Can't be hit with the right hand.
Right now, Lyle is trying to stay either outside his reach or inside those long arms.
You know, I think he's trying to smother, see whether or not the younger man, Cooney, is going to try to punch himself out.
Cooney is a converted southpaw. That left hook, the big punch.